Solving linear inequalities is just like solving a linear equality, except for one little rule. If you divide or multiply by a negative, then you must flip the inequality. So think about it this way. If you have 4 and 7, 4, here, make it even easier, negative 4 and 7. Negative 4 is less than 7. So, if we divide by a negative 1 to each side, that's what we're doing here, dividing by a negative, then what we would get is this. This would now be 4 and negative 7. Now which one's bigger? The 4. And so the inequality now flipped. So if you divide by a negative, you're switching everything. What was small is now large, and what's large is now small. That's the way you can think about it. Everything is flipped. Okay, so let's try solving one. So we solve it like a normal inequality. Let me use blue. We subtract the 1. And then now we divide. But since we're dividing by a negative, we must flip the inequality. And that's our answer. All right. So now we still need to graph it. So you put a negative 1. X is greater. So we shade this way. And since it's less than or equal to, we have to use a bracket. And then the solution set in interval notation would be negative 1, comma, infinity. And there you go. All right. What if you have fractions? Same rule applies. You find the LCD, which is 6. Multiply the left and the right side by 6. That allows us to reduce. And then we can distribute. And there it is, simplified. So now we need to put a K on one side or the other. I'm going to put it on the left. Add the 4. And then divide by negative 6. And again, since we divided by a negative, we must flip the inequality. All right, so it's 23 over 6, but I don't want to use that. So if I do 23 divided by 6, it'll give me the decimal, 3.83 repeating. Put the repeater bar on there. We shade left because it's less. Put a bracket because it equals. Put a negative infinity. So it's from negative infinity to 3.83 repeating. And that's our solution. All right. Next one. If you see, we want to start with the parenthesis inside. So that's 3x minus, put a 1 there, x plus 4. So that's 3x minus x minus 4. So that's 2x minus 4. Now that's fully simplified. Let's bring down the bracket, which is now a parenthesis. 10x minus 20. And then simplify the other side, which is minus 2x plus 8. Add the 2x. Add the 20 to put it on the other side. So that's 12x and 28. I almost put a plus in there. 28. Now we divide by 12, and since we are dividing by a positive, that x, that absolute, that inequality will stay the same. Reduce it. So that's 7/3. And if we divide that, we get 2.3 bar. 7 divided by 3. And there it is. And it's greater, so we shade to the right with a parenthesis. That's an arrow, by the way. An infinity, and so our answer would be 2.3 bar, comma, infinity. And there it is. All right, so that's graphing inequalities. I mean, solving inequalities. So it's exactly the same as solving a linear equation, except if you divide by the negative, you must flip the inequality. All right? All right, these are called compound inequalities because we have two inequalities in one. So if you just kind of think about it this way, if I cover this side right there, get rid of it, it's just a normal inequality. So the way we would solve it is to go minus 4, minus 4. So 2z is less than 12. then divide by 2, divide by 2, so z is less than 6. The thing is it's not, it's double. So when you do it, you also have to just minus 4 over there. See, it's two inequalities in one. So if I were to cover this side, that's that inequality that we're solving. So it's minus 4 minus 4, less than or equal to minus 10, divide by 2, and there it is. So when we solve these, you want to do it all together. Minus 4, minus 4, minus 4, three sides. So it's minus 10, less than or equal to 2z, less than 12. And then divide by 2 to all three parts. And there it is, except that's supposed to be less than. There we go. So when we write it, they will always look like this. It's going to be from negative 5 to 6. And you shade in between them. That's what we're trying to do, is find the two numbers that our solutions are between. And there's a bracket on the negative 5, parenthesis on the 6. So when we write it, it's negative 5, comma 6, parenthesis. All right, one more to do. So same rule applies, this is 5. So if we were to cover 1, you still have to multiply by 5. So we multiply all three parts by 5. So that's negative 10. Cancel the 5 in the middle. Gives us a 50. And then subtract 1. It's 49. Divide by negative 2. And then plug in your calculator, and that gives us 5.5. And that's 24.5. Just to double check. 11 divided by 2, 5.5. 49 divided by 2. 49 divided by 2, 24.5. There it is. So we're going from 5.5, so it's a negative, to negative 24.5. Do you see something wrong here? How are we going from a larger to a smaller? That doesn't make sense. On a number line, the negatives are over here and the positives are over here. It's because we forgot to do something. If you divide by a negative, you have to flip the inequality, which makes the negative 24.5 over here and the 5.5 over here. You now see that the arrows are pointed in the opposite direction. If you want, you can Photoshop it. So put the negative where it's supposed to be, 5.5 where it's supposed to be, and then put it in the same direction. You see how it's still saying x is less than 5.5, but it's greater than 24.5. Negative 24.5. It still says x is greater than negative 24.5 and less than 5.5. Make sure the arrows are pointed in the same direction. You don't have to do this, but make sure when you put on the graph, they are in the proper location. And the negative 24.5 is on the left with a bracket, because that's where the negatives go. And the 5.5 is on the right with a parenthesis, because that's where the positives go. And then we shade in between. So the answer is negative 24.5. comma 5.5. And that's inequalities, graphing and solving.